In this demonstration, I'm going to show you how to use the editor's control to set up a fleet race with multiple boats. The first thing you have to do when you launch the game is, at this point, hold down your right mouse button and keep it held down and type the word friends, F-R-I-E-N-D-S, and release the button. This will put you into a mode that allows multiple competitors. Go to the word editors now, click on that, click on a new race, and we'll just grab one here, La Trinité, okay? Now, if I zoom in with the scroll wheel, this is what I'm getting. If I put the mouse to the edge of the screen, you can see how it pans over and back and down and so on. I'm going to try and zoom into this area here. Now, each of those blocks, that's about a good width for a melange boat width. So you can see down here at the bottom, there's a yellow highlighted icon with a boat and a green line. That's the start line. I'm going to click on the start line there once, and I'm going to click on it again there. Now you see we have a start line. If I don't like that, I just right click it, and I right click it again, it's gone. Let's put a little bit of an offset in. So left click and left click. A start line appears. Next thing is to put in some buoys. These ones over here in the far right are a gate. This is just a regular buoy. So I'll put in a regular buoy right there. Shows a line up to that. It's going upwind. The wind is from the north. This is oriented from the north. I'm going to put another buoy down in here, like that. That's my downwind mark. Just to finish this up quickly, we'll just go to the finish, and you can see a yellow highlighted icon with a boat and a red line. Click right on that there, and you'll see start and finish are the same line. Now, all you have to do now, really, is spawn some boats. You have no boats in this course. So you click on that with a boat symbol. I click once, and a boat will appear. If I click it again, it will change directions. That's good to know if you want to spawn them all, let's say, on a starboard tack like these are. So I'm going to spawn a few on starboard tack, and then I'm going to go over and I'm going to click it around, spawn a few in port tack, just to confuse things. So there I've got 8 boats. Okay, that's good. Now go over to parameters here on the right under the compass, and you'll see the word, this menu appear. It's here you choose time of start, for instance, 1 minute start, a fleet race, and so on. It's at this point here where you see AI opponents that you must click that up. Just keep clicking it till, say, 8 boats appear, or 7 or 4 or whatever. You can do things like start with a sail up, yes. Here's where the wind direction shows from and the strength. Click that up. See, it goes up different. We'll leave it at 6. Shifty, on stable winds, no wind shifts, stable, oscillating, those are your choices. And the degree and how long it'll take, and whether there's a wind disturbance, which is another little novel thing. So we're all good. Other stuff you don't really need to know much about here. So I'll go OK. Now I have to save this race. Down here at the bottom, I'll go save. Click under the word unnamed there, and you have to backspace through that. I'll just call it Demo 2. Demo 2, and save it. It says it's been saved. I can now exit. And I can leave this editor screen and go back into the main screen. This, choose a solo race. Choose a custom race. That's one you just created. There's Demo 2 showing. I'll click on Demo 2. It shows everything. Now, at this stage, if you want to sail that race and want to change things, you can change this. I can change that to Melish right now or so on. I've got a bunch of boats here. We'll leave it at Melish. I'll just play this quickly, and you'll see that we have created a race. With this many boats, you can see they're going in the directions I set them up into. And we're going to just sail that race. that's how to start a race. Hope you can figure that out.